So how common is it to have both ADHD and autism? And when individuals do have these two issues, what does it look like when they overlap? Hi, I'm Dr. James Thatcher. I'm a licensed clinical psychologist, and today I'm going to go over the prevalence of having both ADHD and autism, other known as AuDHD, along with several different areas of how these two interplay with one another. So living with both autism and ADHD, other known as AuDHD, can have a lot of overlap between one another. For instance, difficulties focusing, social interactions. However, they also bring their own unique struggles. For individuals with both autism and ADHD, having these two issues can sometimes feel overwhelming. But understanding how they overlap, how they interplay with one another, and how they're different can give us some key insights and how to cope with them. So autism and ADHD, or attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, has gotten a lot of notoriety here lately. And the more and more research that comes out, people are noticing that these two issues are very much comorbid with one another, meaning that they occur at the same time. Let me walk you through what both the DSM-TR and current research says about these two co-occurring issues. So research that's been coming out in the past few years has consistently found that autism and ADHD co-occur with one another. So in a large meta-analysis meaning to where they take lots of different clinical studies and combine them, and they look at the stats in each and every single one of them, and they run their own stats on the overarching findings of all of those things. The Journal of American Academy Child and Adolescent Psychiatry back in 2019, they found that 28% of children that had autism also had ADHD. However, when looking at clinical samples instead of community samples, they found that this percentage drastically jumped up to 50 to 70%. So looking in the other direction, looking at folks with ADHD, the Journal of European Child and Adolescent Psychiatry back in 2019 suggested that 15 to 25% of those individuals also had autism, especially when the study focused on social communication difficulties. A comprehensive review of neuropsychiatric disease and treatment back in 2020 found that the pooled prevalence of having both ADHD and autism in children was 40 to 50%, making it the most co-occurring disorder between those two issues. So before I go on and I give you one more study, you may be asking yourself, wow, these numbers jump quite a bit, 40 to 50, or even before I was talking about 50 to 70%. So again, we're not just focusing on one single study. I'm trying to give you, and these different journals, we're discussing a range of different studies, and they use different methods to find these out. But any way that you cut it, it's significant. In another research paper published back in 2022 in Nature of Neurology, they found that genetic factors may explain most of this co-occurrence, to where they found it happened 30 to 80%. See that huge jump there? Again, they're looking at different studies. And again, regardless, no matter how you cut it, this is pretty significant. Let's go over some ways that these two issues can interplay with one another and create some very unique difficulties for folks with AuDHD. So number one that I'm going to go over is sensory sensitivities and impulsivity. So sensory sensitivities can be a part of both autism and ADHD. And impulsivity, that is going to be more with the ADHD. So sensory sensitivities, that's looking at folks getting overwhelmed with lights, with smells, with loud noises. So when they're out in public, say at a crowded mall or in a restaurant where there's lots of people talking, there's lots of smells going on, there's different fluorescent lights that are going on, it can be overwhelming. And then when you couple this with impulsivity, so not thinking through, reacting instead of thinking, sometimes you can run into folks that have a meltdown or just want to leave or need to leave. And I should also say that having both of these things can make that environment just chaotic and disturbing and even painful. So again, they may just want to leave, and this may lead to them becoming burnt out and overwhelmed and needing to get out of there. Number two is difficulty with focus and attention. So folks with ADHD are going to have a hard time policing their attention. They're going to get distracted, disorganized. Folks with autism can have something what's called hyperfocus, to where they're just laser focused on one single thing, and it's hard for them to move on from that. So when you have a combination of these two, you're going to have difficulty with prioritizing what needs to be done. You're going to have issues with disorganization. You're going to have issues with not just procrastination, but putting things off to the point that it's impairing. So what this looks like at work and school is, you know, kids may put off getting their homework done on time or studying on time. At work, it's going to create difficulties meeting deadlines, and it's going to create issues with being consistently productive. So number three is social communication struggles. So folks on the autism spectrum are going to have difficulties in being able to pick up on social cues and rules. They're going to have trouble engaging in conversations. They're going to come off as quirky or say things a little awkward now and again. And folks with ADHD may not be paying attention to those social cues. So they may interrupt you. They may talk over you. They may talk at you and not really get in the moment that they're making a social faux pas or a mistake. And then when you have both of these issues combined, to where you're not picking up on the social cues, and then on top of that, not understanding them, well, then that can leave individuals feeling very isolated and alone, and that something is wrong with them. They can also feel misunderstood and difficulty navigating communication that can lead them to feeling just out of sync with other folks or singled out. Again, kind of alone and not able to fit in. And all of these things can lead to depression and other mental health issues. So number four is executive functioning and organization. So folks with ADHD can have difficulty being able to plan, being able to prioritize, being able to think ahead of time. Both autism and ADHD can have executive functioning difficulties. So what is executive functioning? So that's decision-making, forward planning, managing our time. So folks with ADHD can have difficulties with all of those things, prioritizing things, putting things off, being impulsive. But folks on the autism spectrum can have cognitive rigidities, needing things to be a certain way for them, along with difficulties in being flexible. So when you have both of these issues, it can make it very difficult for even just daily tasks like meal planning or what you're going to be doing next at work and prioritizing that, or how to prioritize your homework and getting that done on time. This is going to lead individuals with ADHD to feel frustrated with themselves, the people around them, and feeling very misunderstood because others around them may not be able to fully understand these difficulties. Number five is emotional regulation and stress management. Folks with ADHD and autism can get overwhelmed emotionally. With autism, it brings a heightened sensitivity to emotions, to where they can feel overwhelmed by them and difficulty expressing them. While ADHD can lead to impulsive reactions, feeling very frustrated, and becoming irritable. And when you combine these two things, it can lead to a lot of anxiety and emotional burnout and getting depressed. So when you're having both of these issues, what becomes crucial is stress management. Being able to know yourself. What are your triggers? How can you self-soothe? How can you set up the environment around you, and not just at your home, but at your work too, so you don't feel so overwhelmed? And how are you going to be able to communicate some of these things with other people so they can understand? And that leads me to number 6, managing stigma and misunderstanding. Living with both of these difficulties with autism and ADHD, it compounds on one another. It makes it even more difficult to have both of these things. And how these two issues interplay, like I've gone through already and we'll go through a little bit more, makes it even more difficult. And unfortunately, being in a neurotypical world, many people are unaware or ignorant of how these two things interplay with one another. And what that's going to lead to, unfortunately, is a lot of stereotyping, judging, and a lot of misunderstanding. So with folks with ADHD, other people may think of them as just being lazy or disorganized. And a person with autism may be perceived as weird, awkward, or antisocial. Individuals with ADHD, it can feel isolating, and you can feel self-alienated. I don't fit in anywhere. What's wrong with me? And that's especially going to be the case when you're in an environment and around other people that don't understand how these things interact with one another. And lastly, that leads me to number 7. So finding effective support. I can't tell you how many times that I've worked with people that have gone to therapy, and even though their therapist worked with them on their ADHD, like being able to organize things and slow down, how to prioritize, but didn't work with them on their autism, and sometimes vice versa. So knowing that you have both of these issues is key. You're going to be able to be educated. You're going to be able to have a lot of grace with yourself and be able to self-advocate. And on top of that, you're going to be more effective and have access to and be able to advocate for more effective treatments. And it's going to help tailor therapy for you. So having a therapist with a background and working with neurological disorders, where it's not just ADHD, but autism as well, having a therapist that can see you through that lens first is going to be much more effective than just having a therapist that treats you like you're neurotypical, or that you just have one of these disorders instead of both. Because it creates, as I've just discussed, a unique set of challenges. So in conclusion, even though this creates a unique set of challenges, it also creates an opportunity for growth. How do we manage our stress? How do we advocate for ourselves? How can we change our environment to help us be most successful? And that's kind of the point. Knowing that you have ADHD and autism, you can have a lot of compassion and self-awareness and validation, and not just from other people, but from within yourself. And in that way, you don't just have to get through life. You can start to thrive. So guys, if you found this video helpful, please hit like and subscribe. Also, feel free to comment down below. All of these things help the math monster known as the YouTube algorithm send these videos out to like-minded people. If you're interested in more videos, I not only talk about autism, but I also have a lot of videos on child and adolescent mental health issues. So please go ahead and stick around and check those out. All right, take care. Bye-bye.